We're standing in a punt on the Clyde River very early on a Sunday morning. We're ready to go try to sample some oysters and talk about the McAsh family business. We chose the Clyde River because it's so clean and pristine. And right now we're harvesting some oysters. So I'll open one up. And this is what we call like the premium quality, top quality oyster. And it's gonna taste great, I know. They're the oysters that we're sending direct to restaurants, direct to our oyster bar, and also overseas.
We grow three different types of oysters on the farm now. Traditionally it was just Sydney rock oysters, but now we're doing Ngazi, which is another native oyster. It's becoming quite popular. And Pacific oysters, which is very common around the world, but have a really unique flavour when we grow them here in the Clyde River.
It takes 3 years to grow an oyster. We catch our own oysters. We have a nursery lease, which is nice and sheltered and close to the shed because we have to work those oysters quite often. We then move oysters up to the back of the river here where they grow for the majority of their life. There's less marine fouling up in these areas. And then the oysters are finished and harvested back down here at the front of the river where there's a good mix of oceanic and estuarine water. It creates a fat, plump oyster with like fantastic flavour.
Behind us is the old way of cultivating oysters, stick and tray techniques, and that's how I inherited my farm. And we've now changed over to a new single seed plastic basket systems. The cultivation systems we use are really modern and OH&F friendly. Anyone can come out here and help me harvest oysters and enjoy the river. We traditionally harvest about 50,000 dozen per year. We're currently expanding on that production. There's an unlimited demand for oysters, especially oysters of top quality that we grow here on the south coast.
Anyone in Australia can order oysters direct from us, and we can have oysters to them within 48 hours. We are a different kind of oyster farmers. We own an oyster bar. I go from harvesting oysters and being out in the river during the day to shaking cocktails at night. The oyster bar has been the best thing we've ever done. We've got control of our product right to the end consumer, and it exposes us to restaurateurs and magazines and the people who really enjoy our product. I'm looking to build an oyster empire. So it's really about lifting production, export sales, really sort of taking Australian oysters to the rest of the world.